Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On this episode, let's take a look at what you can do when you've got this persistent nagging pop-up window appearing in Safari that won't go away even after you quit and restart Safari. So I occasionally get emails about a situation like this. You're browsing the web in Safari and you hit an alert like this. Now you're smart enough to know that this is just a scam. There's no way they know anything about your computer. It's just a simple script on the web page that any web developer can create that just gives you this false information here. But you don't want to hit that OK button because you don't know what's behind it. In this case, it's probably nothing. And usually it's just more scam information trying to convince you to download something. But it could actually be something harmful or just more tricks, and you just don't want to go there. So what do? You go and you quit Safari because you can't close the window here. This dialog box here is only one way out and you can't get to Safari behind it. So no problem. You quit. The only problem with that is that when you relaunch Safari, it's going to reopen that page automatically and there you are again. It looks like you're stuck, but you're not stuck at all. So all you need to do is quit Safari. And by the way, if for some reason this is clever enough to actually prevent you from quitting, you can always force quit with Command Option Escape and you could select Safari and force quit. But it's not necessary in this case. I can just gracefully quit like that. And I'm going to relaunch Safari now just as before, but I'm going to hold the Shift key down. And what the Shift key does is it does not open the previously open window. So it starts Safari off fresh. So you can see that window is gone now. It's not going back to that page and I don't have anything to worry about. I just continue to move on. Now that page is still there in my history so I can bring it back up easily. And I should note that there are various ways that you can run into this. One is that you've clicked on a link to a site that actually is a scam. Another one is that the site is actually real, but the server that the site is on has been infected. This is nothing that can hurt you. This is something that just somebody broke into their server because they had a weak password or something, and then they installed something that looked like this on there. So people think they're going to a legitimate site, and it was previously a legitimate site, but now they've added this code that brings this up. This will be very effective because if you go to the site all the time, say it's a newspaper site or something, and you kind of learn to trust that site, then finally they're showing you this message. Now you think, uh oh, well, the site I trust is now telling me this. But it's just a matter of that site having a security issue and the result being that everybody's seeing this message. Everybody is seeing this message, not just you. And it's just a scam, and hopefully the site will fix it. So those types of sites are. They're not really viruses or adware of any kind. They're just little tricks, visual tricks. However, if you are infected with real adware, maybe you installed some software without realizing that it also put adware on your computer, Apple does have a really handy page for removing that. So if you have a more serious situation than what I just outlined, then you want to go to this URL here, and Apple has all the information you need. You don't have to purchase anything. You don't have to install anything. And you want to be careful not to, because there's a lot of scam software out there that pretends to fix your computer but actually just makes things worse. This page here will walk you through any steps you need to get rid of any type of adware. I'll address these steps in a future video a little more, but if you need it now, here's where to get it from Apple.